comes up victorious. God, in human flesh, makes himself available to Satan for the conflict, and in the midst of our weakness and the world that we've rendered weak, he has the victory, not to show us how we can do it, but to show us that he did. Because it's only one step in undoing the curse from that day in the Garden of Eden where we sinned. Jesus comes into the world to keep the law of God perfectly, to resist the devil. At this and every turn, you notice the text tells us he'll be back in an opportune time. Jesus will resist Satan and he will stomp on him over and over all the way up to the cross. And at this moment of pivotal cosmic events, when the devil believes he has killed the Son of God, Jesus is actually atoning for the sins of the world and undoing the curse. Jesus gets it right. Jesus gets it perfect. Jesus does it sinless because you and I are perpetually and eternally wrapped with sin, and the best, our very best, our first place grand champion blue ribbon best is always our best mediocrity, our best weakness, our best halfway defeat, somewhat maybe victory sometimes. Jesus triumphs over it all so that he can give us the trophy, so that he can bear the scars of his atonement even after his resurrection into heaven, showing the Father that our sins are blotted out, that we will be made new, that we will be made clean, that we are weak, but he is infinitely strong. In Jesus' name, amen. God the Father in heaven, God the Son, Redeemer of the world, God the Holy Spirit, hear us. Be gracious and merciful to us. From all sin, from all error, from all evil, from the crafts and assaults of the devil, good Lord, by the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your holy nativity, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation, by your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial, by your glorious resurrection and ascension, and by the coming of the Holy Ghost, the Comforter, good Lord. In all times of precious memory and joy, especially for David, Rhonda, and David, by the illumination of your grace, good Lord. In all time of our tribulation, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment, good Lord. We poor sinners implore you to rule and govern your holy Christian church, to preserve all pastors and ministers of your church in the true knowledge and understanding of your wholesome word, and to sustain them in holy living, to put an end to all schisms and causes of offense, to bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived, to beat down Satan under our feet, to send faithful laborers into your harvest, and to accompany your word with your grace and spirit, good Lord. To give to all peoples concord and peace, to preserve our land from discord and strife, to give our country your protection in every time of need, to direct and defend all in authority, to bless and protect our magistrates and all our people, good Lord. To watch over and help all who are in danger, necessity, sickness, and tribulation, especially Mary, Andrea, Robin, Joan, Marv, Ross, Steve, Kathy, David, Vernon, Scott, Margaret, Abby, Andy, Ethan, Shelley, David, Norm, Nicholas, Margie, Landon, Jim, Tabitha, Carl, Mira, Ezekiel, Patricia, Rich, Debbie, Richard, Jeff, and Rhonda. Good Lord, to forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts, to give and preserve for our use the kindly fruits of the earth, and graciously to hear our prayers, good Lord. Deliver us, O Lord, strengthen, enlighten, and preserve us. For to you alone we ascribe all glory, honor, and power, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Taught by our Lord and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O Lord, our God, who dwells on high and regards the humble of heart, who sent forth as the salvation of mankind your only begotten Son, our Lord and God, Jesus Christ, look down upon your servants who have bowed their heads before you. Keep us steadfast in baptismal grace, your washing of regeneration. Keep us united with your holy church and numbered with your flock. For blessed are you on the throne of glory in your kingdom, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and to the ages of ages.